everybody, if you can hear me in the parking lot, please honk your horn so I know you can hear me okay. Okay, good. Good. Well, welcome to worship. I'm Pastor Mary Armstrong-Reiner, and I welcome those of you online and those of you in our parking lot to St. John Lutheran Church for worship this morning. It is October 3rd. We have definitely come into fall, and we begin our conversation on stewardship today. We will be talking about how God leads us into the future, into today, and into the future, and the joy we have in giving back to God what God has blessed us with. And so today, Larry Schultz will be speaking today with us to share a little bit at our special time, at offering time today. Thank you all for being with us. For those of you online, if you want to follow along with the service, you can go to our website, stjohngriffin, griffin.org. And on that front page should be a link to our bulletin. So we invite you all to join along with us in worship today. Thank you for joining us, whether you're in person or online. We begin this morning with confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, whose teaching is life, whose presence is sure, and whose love is endless. Amen. Let us confess our sins to the one who welcomes us with an open heart. Like lost sheep, we have gone astray and see scarcity. We turn our faces away from injustice and oppression. We exploit the earth with our apathy and greed. Free us from our sin, gracious God. Listen when we call out to you for help. Lead us by your love to love our neighbors as ourselves. Amen. All have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. By the gift of grace in Christ Jesus, God makes us righteous. So we are invited to receive with glad hearts the forgiveness of all our sins. Amen. Our mission here at St. John is we trust God and invite you to experience God's inclusive love. Our gathering hymn is Come Ye Thankful People Come on page 12 in the back of your bulletin.
Come ye thankful people, come.
easier for you. I just want to make sure you all know that those are in the parking lot today. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. We continue with the Kyrie on page 13.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm 24 will be read responsibly. The earth is the Lord's and all that is in it, the world and those who live in it. For he has founded it on the sea and established it on the river. Who shall ascend to the hill of the Lord, and who shall stand in his holy place? Those who have clean hands and pure hearts. They will receive blessing from the Lord and vindication from the God of our salvation.
Touch the company of those who see him, who seek the face of God.
Second lesson is the letter to Galatians, chapter 5, ending in chapter 6. By contrast, the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. There is no law against such things. Those who belong to Christ Jesus have crucified the flesh with its passions and desires. If we live by the Spirit, let us also be guided by the Spirit. Let us not become conceited, competing against one another, envying one another. So let us not grow weary in doing what is right, for we will reap at harvest time if we do not give up. So then, whenever we have an opportunity, let us work for the good of all, and especially for those of the family of faith. Word of God, word of life, thanks be to God.
Keeping them, and What I found interesting in what I heard was that when Warren Buffett looks at a company that he's going to buy, he looks at their past 10 years earnings, but he also looks to see how good they are in using their money for what they need. So in other words, he looks at the little things. And if the company does well in the small details, then he sees that they are worth taking a second look at. Because they pay attention not just to the big picture, but to the small things. And they take care of those small things in a good and thoughtful way, so that they use what they have been given in that company to the best of their ability. Now, I don't want to just talk about money, but I want to talk about what this stewardship, this idea that everything we have and who we are belongs to God, that we have been blessed with it, that we have been blessed to be a blessing, that we look to the future, an unknown future, with the known God that we know, that He knows us, that we are loved, that we are seen as children of the light. And I want to talk this morning about joy. I know that last week I had a kind of a come to Jesus sermon, and if you didn't hear it, well, you're welcome to look at it, but you don't have to. But I also, you know, it's easy to focus, and the same is true for me, to focus on what is wrong in the world, what is wrong in our lives. And it doesn't mean that when we're going through hard times, we shouldn't deal with those things, because we need to. Burying our head in the sand, I believe, never works. Maybe for a little while, but the longer we stay buried in the sand, the worse the problem can get if we're not willing to face even the most difficult of challenges. But I want to talk about joy, because I believe that the whole thing of stewardship is about joy. It's about passion. It's about a sense of being thankful. Thankful for who we are. You know, sometimes people will say to me, well, I wish I was like this, or I'm not really like that. But as in a conversation, I had a lot of conversations. I visited a lot of people this last week from the church and talked to a lot of people. And somebody made the comment about, you know, being thankful just for who they are. When was the last time you thank God for being just the way you are? When was the last time that you said, well, I know I'm not very good at that, and I don't do this enough, but I'm thankful, God, that you made me me. Everything we have and who we are is a total blessing. Let us give thanks and count those ways. Joy, as we talk about joy, there's a number of different definitions. One you may know is Jesus, others you, but Jesus first, others second, and you last. But Father James Martin, I've heard him speak online about joy. He says joy is different than happiness, because joy is happiness in God. He says joy has an object, and that object is God. And joy is about a relationship. The relationship we have with God. How often do we give thanks in the midst of crisis and difficulties and struggles and strife, that we even in the midst of pain and uncertainty and doubt, that we can still have joy? Because we have a relationship with God who knows us and loves us, who made us in God's image, male and female. How often do we remember that joy? For in that relationship, it does not matter what is coming. It does not matter when our life is going to end, because even in the midst of those who have lost their lives. A gentleman who had cancer shared with a friend that even though he was sad that he knew the cancer he had was terminal, he had joy in what was to come. Sisters and brothers in Christ, and all those listening who may not be sure about God, today I want to just remind us to be thankful. For out of thankfulness we give back that which has been entrusted to us. We share our gifts, our time, our talents, our treasures. I think about these last 18 months and I know without a doubt that I wouldn't still be here if it wasn't for all of you who have stepped up to the plate to help to usher, to help to read, to help to sing, to help to prepare communion, to help to clean up, to help to be on the church council, to help in so many other ways. I'm thankful that you have shared your time, your talents, and even if you didn't know what you were doing, if you were willing to learn, I'm thankful. Church is not a one-person occupation. Yes, you may have called me and I'm here to serve, but we serve together. For the church is not about one person, except for it's about God and our relationship with God and our hope in Jesus Christ. And we come for all kinds of reasons, but I hope that even in the moments of greatest struggle, we can hang on to that joy. For joy is not fleeting. It's not like happiness that comes and goes. We're happy for a moment. You may be one of those people that's happy when you go shopping. You feel some feeling of the things you have bought. You may be one of those people that's happy when you get to go play golf or go to a ball game or go out to dinner. Those are all things to be happy about, but it's fleeting. It's not a permanent thing. Our moods can change a dozen times or more in a day. Or we could just be kind of right there in the middle. Or we could be up and down, up and down, up and down. But the joy I'm talking about is a remembrance of presence. Of knowing that God is right here, right now with us in this day. And walks with us into the future that we do not know. But we know and love God because God has first loved us. In this stewardship season, we will hear from different people of why they give of themselves, why they give back, why they give of their time, their treasures, their energy, their love, their, and yes, even their money. But I say this, and I mean this, and I've always thought this, that what we give is because we are thankful. And I pray that none of us give more than we can give. Or as we will hear next week, the story of the widow's mite, where God looks just upon the smallest offering as great as that and those who can give more. For it's not about the amount we give, but it's about the willingness, the openness, and the joy in the giving of ourselves and our thankfulness to God. We do it out of love. Love of God. For we have been made managers. Not dishonest managers. But managers who are willing to admit when we have done wrong. Managers who seek forgiveness from God. Managers who aren't trying to buy their way into heaven by any of that which I have named, but rather that we see the gift of grace is freely given by God through Jesus Christ to us. And out of that gift, out of that love, we give thanks. We give back. Because how else can we be for our faith? The tree of life of which we are a part of is alive and blooming and growing. And in this season, being harvested. In this month of October, we give thanks for farmers, for those who are harvesting the fields at this time, for those who will be planting for what will lie into the ground for the winter. We give thanks for all those who work the fields, who collect the harvest, who do it by hand. We give thanks for the good managers who look out for the people who work for them. And we give thanks most of all for God. For God is the ultimate manager, the one who looks out for us even in the most difficult of times, the one who leads us through unknown times and leads us into the future. Let us give thanks for the joy, the relationship we have been blessed with God. And let us hold on to that joy even when happiness is fleeting. And let us not count the cost of what it takes from us. But let us instead see it as part of our thanksgiving. A thanksgiving back to God. Let us have joy this day. Let us give thanks in all the ways God calls us to, both in the church and in the world, in our homes, and in our lives. For we are a grateful people. Our hymn of the day is Shout to the Lord, Make Full Sea.
Jesus, I say, Lord, there is no place.
the faith in which we believe. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again, he ascended into heaven, he is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Our response to the prayer today is, hear our prayer. Holy One, you have raised up faithful leaders throughout history. Empower those discerning a call to ministry and all that they continue to be formed for the sake of the gospel. Bless the ministry of Augustinian Lutheran School in Guatemala and St. Johannes in Bavaria. We pray for Grace Missions and Shamaw Orphanage in Haiti. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We desire for us to not be alone and to live in community with one another. Strengthen relationships between nations and people, that we celebrate and support one human family. We pray for those who serve in the military, especially Chance and Sequoia. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We share in our experiences and struggles. Bless all who live with any mental or physical disability. Inspire creative communities, spaces, and environments that are accessible and hospitable. We especially pray today for Kathleen, Charlie, William, Bob, Susan, and David, Maureen, April, Andy and June, John, Sarah, Catherine, Terry, Bill, Marcus, Charlie, Gary, and Bush. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Bless those celebrating birthdays, Chris and Frank, and those celebrating anniversaries, Rick and Kathy. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We lift up all others we name in our hearts or on our lips at this time. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Gracious God, we also ask today for safe travel for those we know in our community. We especially lift up Steve and Sandra. We also ask for that for Phyllis and for Mark and Laura as they travel. And we just ask that you would bless their time away, bring them back safely to us, and we thank you for the safe return of Cheryl and Vaughn. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Receive these prayers, O God, and those in our hearts known only to you through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always, and also with you. We share the peace with one another today by honking our horns and giving thanks for the peace between each one of us. And now I want to invite Larry Schultz, who's been working with me these last few years and many other years in St. John in a variety of ways, but also especially on stewardship. I'm very grateful for Larry, for his leadership and his willingness to serve in a variety of ways, and Larry will be sharing with us this week.
Thank you for hearing this. Part of our stewardship campaign, but every year we do this, and we thank God for the opportunity to do this. The theme for this year is trusting God today and for the future. Walking a disciple path. The Gospel of Matthew has deep teaching using the medium of parables. One of them talks about a treasure hidden in a field. The passage is very short, just one verse, so it lends itself to rich imaginative consideration. The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure hidden in a field. When a man found it, he hid it again. But then in his joy, he went and sold all he had and bought that field. I like to picture this story in my mind using imaginative liberty in line with Henry Miller. that ancient little reminder that it wasn't uncommon for people to bury their savings for protection. Sometimes people would be forced to leave their land with their treasure still buried, unknown to the public. It's difficult to verify, but there was apparently a law that if you owned a plot of land and found a treasure buried there, it was yours to keep. So, if you were a sharecropper, it would be wise to keep your eyes open for buried treasure. I imagine the man is a sharecropper plowing in another man's field. Clink! His plow hits something. The man stops, begins digging around, and guess what? There's a treasure chest there. He breaks open the latch. Unbelievable! Inside are gold coins all stacked up. The man looks around to see if anyone's watching, because he doesn't own the field. He's very shrewd, though, so he covers it back up and reburies it. And the parable goes, when the man found it, he hid it again. The man decides to sell everything he has to buy the field because of the value of the treasure he found. Now he's overjoyed because the treasure is his. One way to look at this parable is to say that we're the man. We stumble on the treasure, which is the love of God in Jesus. We go and we sell everything we have. All of our personal wishes and our dreams follow Jesus. But there is another way, a deeper way, to see the parable. What if the man is God? And what if you are the treasure? You may say, come on, that's not the way it's supposed to go. Well, elsewhere in the gospel, Jesus tells another story about a man who went and scattered seed in the field. And the man in the story was God. Another story in Luke tells of a man who left 99 sheep and went to look for the lost one. Who was the shepherd? It was God in Jesus. Still another story tells of a woman who lost her valuable coin. She swept all over the house and turned everything upside down to find it because it meant so much to her. Who was the woman in the parable? She was God in Jesus. What if you're the treasure in the field? And God came along to dig you up out of the dirt, buy that field, bring you back home, polish you up, and use you for the purposes for which you were designed. Is it hard to think of yourself as such a treasure? It's hard to think of St. John Church as such a treasure. Well, it isn't hard for Jesus to think of it that way, I think. God is offering a way to find a home designed specifically for us. This is the path to find God, a path. It's not a path for our searching to find a hidden God. God has already done the search. For us, it is the path of awakening to the presence of the one who gave everything. What we have is a treasure and a trust from God, placed by God into our care and our memory. So, I return to the theme, trusting God today for our spirit.
During this season, we will be singing an offertory hymn. We are an offering, and on page 15 in the back of your bulletin. Lord Jesus took bread, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and now he gives it to each and every one of us, and he said, take and eat, this is my body, given for you for the remembrance of me. Do this for the remembrance of me. Again, after supper, he took the cup, he blessed it, he gave it to all to drink, saying, take and drink, this is my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me. Remembering, therefore, his life given for us and his rising from the grave, he awaits his coming again to share with us the everlasting peace. By your Spirit, nurture and sustain us with this meal. Strengthen us to serve all in hunger and want. And by this bread and cup, make of us the body of your Son. Through him, our glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, both now and forever. Amen. God, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. So, a few announcements. So, I know that we have some wonderful animals with us today. So, after I go and give everybody communion, then I will come back to you and give a blessing for your animals. We do this because tomorrow is the anniversary, the birthday of St. Francis of Assisi. He was known as the saint of creation. He loved all animals. There's lots of wonderful stories about him. It's been a practice of St. John to do that for years. We were not able. I can't remember if we did it last year or not. I think we may have done it in the parking lot too. But anyway, so we look forward to that. If your animal isn't here, I have blessed a few animals at their homes this week. I also will be willing to travel in the next couple weeks, or if you bring a picture of your animal, I will be glad to do that too. I have got to enjoy a number of animals on my visits this week, and I just delight in all your animals. And we are getting ready to hopefully ourselves to go meet a little black cat this next Saturday. Christopher, my son, wants a black cat. He's going to name it Cooper. So we're going to hopefully go down to Warner Robins, and then we're going to be getting a dog for Sam. So our house will have animals in it for the first time in a very long time in my life. I want to remind you, so for October, our change bucket is going to go. September was for the Thanksgiving meals, and that will help us with some of the purchases we'll be making. So this year we're working with 5 loaves, 2 fish on being one of many churches to bring food for the boxes. And so we encourage, if you are going to purchase those, to look for those now. I know I had trouble finding pumpkin the other day, but we are collecting, the list is in here, I believe it's dressing mix, cranberry sauce, and I think pumpkin. And we will take that offering as well as whatever people bring in the next month to that, and we'll let you know if there's a way to help with that. So I just wanted to let you know that and thank you. And this month's offering will go for the Christmas gifts that we will get for children at Warren Elementary. I will be in touch with them in the next week or so and encourage them to plan ahead, as at least all the news I hear say that there could be a shortage of things at Christmas because of not having enough people and enough drivers to unload all the things that are coming to America. But we aren't going to panic, but we're going to do our best with that. If you have not picked up your Christ in Our Home daily devotional and you want it, Tish and Charlie have it so they can give it to you today. Also, thank you to those who have written cards for Guatemala. But we found out there's more children with the school than we thought, so we are needed some more writing. So Mary Johnson, she'll be helping with communion today. And Mary and Don, come on up and get ready for communion. But Matt, we'll have a few more cards and envelopes if you're willing to write the note, and there's a little thing in it. You're basically just saying, you know, somebody asked me how you're blessed, you just say, your child, their young person, you know, and you can say, you know, I'm from St. John Lutheran, and he lifts you up in prayer. But it also gives you, Pastor Karin asked to say something about hygiene, you know, remember to wash your hands after you, you know, just something about hygiene, brush your teeth every day or whatever. So, and to remind them that they are loved by God. So there's a little note in there. We'll be collecting for the next 2 weeks. If you have it at home, bring it by. Lynn will be back on Tuesday through Friday, 9 to 3. Or bring them back on Sunday. Those of you who may still have them at home, and if you're willing to do another packet of four, please take those, and we thank you for that. Also, I want to make sure everybody knew that Cheryl Browning, those who've been here a long time, Cheryl Browning, a former member, we found out last week, died on August 31st in Dothan, Alabama, and we lift her family up in our prayers as they grieve her loss, at the loss of her. And the latest on Butch is that he is holding his own. He's still in the hospital. He still has COVID pneumonia, but he is holding his own. So we lift him up for prayer. We are working to get back into the sanctuary. That will take, once we can get everything worked out, then we'll announce it. And 2 weeks later, we'll be back in. Hopefully, sometime in October, if not by the beginning of November, we will be back in. The church council has voted and has said that there will be no exceptions at this time, that everyone who comes to worship Sunday or Wednesday will need to wear a mask for worship. So I just want to make sure you are aware of that. That's it for announcements. Thank you all so much for being here, and those of you online, we're always grateful for you. We're thankful for any support we can get. If you are watching and you would like to support the work that we are doing here at St. John Lutheran, you can go again to our website page, stjohngriffin.org, and there is a place there called Tidely that you can give an offering to us, or you could drop it off or bring it by. But we thank everyone for God continuing to call us and for our work here in this community, in our county, our state, in our world. And so we bring all that together, and we give thanks to God for what God has entrusted to us. And now receive God's blessing. People of God, you are Christ's body, bringing new life to a suffering world. The Holy Trinity, one God, bless you now and forever. Amen. And the hymn, closing hymn, is To Be Your Presence on page 16. Transform lives. Go in peace. You are the body of Christ. Thanks be to God.